So hello, my name's Richard Simcott, and I'm here in Skopje with Danny Ferguson, who made a very big effort to come and visit me following a conference in niche on linguistics.
Yes.
And what I thought was interesting was to actually just talk to him about his field of study. As some of you may know, my background is that I went to university to study languages as a philologist, I guess you'd say, in many countries. And so I'm not actually a linguist, and I would never call myself a linguist the same way as I would never call myself a translator, even though I have done courses in translation. And the same with interpretation, I'm not an interpreter, even though I've done courses in interpreting. Likewise for linguistics, it's a very broad field as well, I guess. So what field of linguistics is your sort of speciality?
Well, for my studies, I focus on semantics and syntax. Mm-hmm. So I work with language structure, particularly for the English language, and I look at semantics behind them. So I break down the meaning of a sentence from the meaning of its parts.
Okay. So in terms of an example of what you might look at in language, can you give us an idea of maybe something you've looked at in the past or something you're looking at now that might be an interesting example for people to hear about?
Well, right now in particular for semantics, areas that you can look at are the interaction of tense and aspect within the language, and in particular African-American English. African-American English is it's a dialect, actually it's a variety of English that is basically made up of general English features, but has a specific African-American counterpart to it, which differs in tense and aspectual features, intonational features, and auxiliary patterns. These patterns are featured in mainstream American English, but in African-American English we have more varieties, okay. Essentially.
Okay, what sort of variety would you... Is there an example that you can give of something that would appear in African-American English and not in standard English?
We have different markers. An aspectual marker would be complete if done, for example, where in comparison to standard English, you would have I ate something or I done ate something. And the latter sense would be the action of eating is completed and over with, its perfective aspect. Or we have different markers like habitual be, in the sense of the equivalent in standard English would be usually or I always do something. So the buses be yellow is a famous example, and basically means school buses are usually or always yellow.
That's really cool. It's really cool to hear, you know, these kinds of examples that I'm sure many people, especially native English speakers, have probably heard and maybe not considered. And I think this is the key thing with linguistics, isn't it? There may be some overlap when you study a language or languages, that you hear elements, but then linguistics is the science behind going deeper into it and really seeing what's going on.
Exactly. It's linguistics is the scientific study of language. Mm-hmm. So a good example to illustrate that would be an athlete. If you're a really, really good athlete, you're just able to run and you win all these competitions. That doesn't necessarily mean you know the physics behind what your body is doing in order for you to win these competitions. Right. And as a linguist, we really focus on the mechanics of language. What is it about language that makes it work? And actually, as a linguist, if I just say I'm a linguist, you have no idea what I actually do.
Yeah, because there are so many varieties, like you said. You're talking about semantics as one area of linguistics, and maybe other well-known ones. I think we were talking this evening about field linguistics, where people go and deconstruct languages,
right?
Especially tribal languages or languages we want to, document and conserve.
Right.
And they'll go in and look at the sound patterns, look at the grammatical features of the language, and document it in a scientific way.
Exactly.
Yeah. And so, going on from that then, do you really need to speak a language to be a linguist?
No, you don't, and that's actually the biggest question that you're asked. Well, the most frequent question that you're asked when you say you're a linguist, how many languages do you speak? And that's completely irrelevant to actually what a linguist does. you can be a linguist and monolingual, or you can also be a linguist who happens to be a foreign language enthusiast and speak lots of languages. Mm-hmm. But the key component of being a linguist is simply the scientific study of a language. Mm-hmm. And you also have to realize that every language has its own set of linguistic principles as well. So I made a point to say that I study English linguistics because Spanish has its own set of linguistic principles, French linguistics, German linguistics, etc.
Wow. I think that was a really nice introduction to the difference between what a language learner is, speaking different languages, and then really a bit of an eye-opener maybe for the difference between that and the kind of thing you do as a linguist. I think we can maybe try and link maybe below, if we can, with a few more places where people can look for more information. If they want to look at, you know, university sites that offer programs in linguistics, it might be a good place to do it under the video. What do you think?
I think that'd be a great idea.
Great. And any questions, get in touch and we'll try and answer.
Definitely.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks so much for your time. It's been a pleasure and great seeing you.
And no, thanks. Thank you, Richard. It's always a pleasure.
Bye-bye.
Ciao.